Okay, we are going to talk today about when you're in EBSCO Discovery Service, which we use to search all of our databases. If you are in this database, how do you use this folder option? This is a really useful option in this database. Let's say you've done a search here, and you're just kind of going through your results to see things that look interesting to you, and you don't want to have to necessarily read them right now. I'm going to say that one looks interesting to me. That one might be interesting. And I'm just kind of telling, looking at the titles, I'm looking at articles that might be interesting to look at later. So I'm just kind of gathering as I go through, instead of having to deal with everyone individually, I just set it aside so I can look at it later. Now later, what I can do is go up here to this folder. And when I click on this folder, all of those articles that I set aside are waiting there for me. And I could open them up and do whatever I would want with them. The only problem with you might be asking yourself, what happens when I end this browsing session? When you end this browsing session, these are all going to disappear. But there's a way around that. What you can do, and this is really pretty cool, within the EBSCO system, what you can do is sign on or sign in, and you can create your own sign on within the database. Now it knows who I am here because I've signed on with this a number of times. But if I go to don't have an account, create one now, you can create an account with EBSCO so that you can have your own personalized folders in here. And anytime you would then log into this database, you could log into your folder within it and have the articles saved as long as you would want to do it. So it's a pretty typical create an account kind of a situation here. And I'm just going to log in. So once I sign in, now in EBSCO, I'm still going to be in the database, but now in my folders, so let's see here. So it knows it's me there. There's my name. And when I look at the folders, I have those articles and I have a lot of other articles. All the articles I added earlier were project management. And then here's articles on all sorts of different topics in here. These are things that I have saved to the folder in past sessions. And then I saved it into my personalized folder. Now when I'm coming back, they're still there. And then also you might notice right over here, I have all these subfolders within this folder. These are subfolders that I've created. So, and if I wanted to create a new folder, I could just click new there. And then maybe this would be my project management folder. And then I could organize articles however I would want to. So now, over here on this side, we've got a project management folder. And if there's, let me take a look here and see. Let's say there was some of these. This one looks good to me. This was a project management one. I'd like to move that one. And let's see if any other ones look good to me that I had set aside. How about this one? I'll set those two aside into my project management folder. I just click on them. And then I click move to, and then I find the folder, project management. And then now they're out of this general folder, and now they're moved over into my project management folder. And I have all these other folders saved that I wanted to look at later. And if any time I come back, I can say, okay, my college sports pay articles. Let me click on those articles. And then it'll bring up the articles I had set aside to save in that folder. Now, when I sign out, it will just go back to being the regular EBSCO Discovery Service or EBSCO database. When you go in there, if I click on the folder now, this would be when you first open it up. There's not going to be anything in there. What you have to do if you want to use this feature is sign in and use the sign on that you had created earlier. So when this comes up again, we'll just show you. It saved mine. I told it to save it so I don't have to sign in all the time. And then I sign in. And then it'll go right in. And then now, when I'm in here, it sees all of those folders I had created, and I can just go back. This will save you from, so often I deal with students who use these databases, and they say, well, I found the perfect articles the other day, but I can't remember how to get them. Using this sign-in feature to create your own folders, you could save the articles so you wouldn't lose those perfect articles. So please ask me any questions. I'm always available for your questions. And thanks for watching.